Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Fluctus channel. An important component that is often forgotten when speaking about ship size is her propulsion system. Actually, this component is what enabled the ship to get bigger and bigger and bigger. The background and history of ship engine building reflect a fascinating evolution. In the early days, ships relied on primitive forms of propulsion, like oars and sails. With the Industrial Revolution, steam engines became a game changer, propelling ships faster and more efficiently. However, early engines were bulky and inefficient, but gradual advancements in design and materials led to the development of more powerful and streamlined propulsion systems. Over time, diesel engines and gas turbines took center stage, enhancing efficiency and range. Today, cutting-edge ship engine factories leverage state-of-the-art technology to produce the world's most powerful marine propulsion systems. The Wärtsilä 14RT Flex 96C stands as a pinnacle in diesel ship engines, boasting unparalleled power. With a massive output of 108,920 horsepower, or 80.080 megawatts, it fuels some of the largest vessels on the seas. This two-stroke, straight 14-cylinder beast features a stroke of 960 millimeters and a bore of 2,500 millimeters, emphasizing its robust design. Its technological prowess lies in its common rail fuel injection system, enabling optimal combustion efficiency. The RT Flex technology enhances flexibility in adjusting the engine's operational parameters, ensuring optimal performance across varying conditions. Modern ship engine manufacturing involves precision engineering and sophisticated materials, creating powerhouses that propel vessels across vast oceans. The process starts with designing gas components. Engineers delve into designing and conceptualizing, utilizing advanced software for simulation and modeling. Collaboration between naval architects and mechanical engineers ensures a seamless fusion of design aesthetics and functionality. Exhaustive testing is then conducted. This involves critically examining gas admission valves and measuring valve lift, hydraulics, and control signals. Continuous refinement follows, optimizing for efficiency, emissions, and reliability. Once the design phase is complete, the manufacturing process kicks in, constructing various engine components. Materials selection is paramount, focusing on the capacity to withstand high temperatures, pressures, and stresses within the engine. High-strength alloys, primarily steel or aluminum, are carefully shaped with specialized equipment. Subsequently, machining refines these components to exact specifications using computer-controlled precision tools. The last stage involves the assembly of all engine components into one single and giant machine, the ship engine. This process typically begins with the installation of the engine block, a critical component that serves as the foundation. Then, the cylinder head, housing vital valves and camshafts, is meticulously fitted. Fuel injectors and exhaust manifolds are incorporated to facilitate combustion and emission processes. A crankshaft connecting rods and pistons are installed to convert reciprocating motion into rotational force. Additional systems, such as the lubrication and cooling systems, are carefully integrated to guarantee optimal performance and longevity. During sea trials, the engine, as well as other vital systems, are put into evaluation. Tests such as the ME load test assess the main engine's capacity, while ED tests measure energy efficiency. The engine control room undergoes electrical testing, including bow thruster assessments. This comprehensive testing guarantees the ship's engine's reliability, efficiency, and safety. Over its lifetime, the propulsion system undergoes regular maintenance intervals. Skilled technicians scrutinize components for wear, corrosion, or malfunctions. Routine tasks include changing lubricants, inspecting fuel systems, and monitoring exhaust emissions. Advanced diagnostic tools, such as vibration analysis and thermography, aid in identifying potential issues before they escalate. Beyond routine checkups, scheduled overhauls are vital for prolonged service life. For instance, the maintenance of Boskalis Endurance is carried out at regular intervals by Shuttle. Minimizing downturn is crucial. The vessel must go back quickly to avoid any disruption to the world economy. Thus, the propulsion expert assesses the vessel before docking, leveraging advanced techniques like condition monitoring and oil analyses that give a glimpse into the vessel's condition. The team disassembles and rebuilds components, replacing worn parts and calibrating systems for optimal performance. Alignment checks, cleanliness, and corrosion prevention measures are integral aspects of this process. Crankshafts are another vital component of the marine engine, which requires special attention. The crankshaft is responsible for translating linear motion into rotational force. Over time, wear and tear are inevitable, necessitating skilled hands to renew and revitalize the crankshaft. In 2021, the propulsion system of one of Columbia Ship Management's container vessels faced a critical challenge. The crankshaft was in poor condition, affecting the vessel's overall performance. The ship manager decided to proceed with complete renewal. In the shipyard, Carroll engineers and technicians started with disassembling the engine to reach the crankshaft. Several solid chains were attached to help lift the weight. The team then removed the old crankshaft and carefully installed the new unit, breathing new life into the heart of the ship. In fact, the whole process of installing an engine into the ship's belly is akin to a puzzle. Each component has its designated place, and like puzzle pieces, they must interlock seamlessly to complete the picture. Operators ensure perfect alignment and installation of each part without forcing any piece. With utmost accuracy, the engine finds its home within the ship's belly. Just like merchant ships, U.S. Navy ships are equipped with one of the most advanced propulsion systems. Naval engines are designed for power, versatility, and endurance. They empower the Navy's fleet to conduct strategic missions with precision and agility. Among these systems, we find the Navy gas turbine systems. The Navy uses this type for its high power-to-weight ratios, enabling warships to achieve impressive speeds while maintaining operational flexibility. These systems rely on gas turbines to convert fuel into mechanical energy. Known for their reliability and quick response times, gas turbine systems offer a strategic advantage in naval operations, allowing rapid acceleration and deceleration essential for tactical maneuvers. On a daily basis, mechanical and electrical technicians ensure the proper functioning of turbines, from overseeing fuel and lube oil to managing shaft speed and propeller pitch control. Besides marine propulsion systems, the U.S. Navy employs powerful aeropropulsion technology for its jets. Fighters such as the twin-engine F-18 are fitted with General Electric F-404 engines. This engine has remarkable resilience under diverse conditions. It can withstand both stalls and flameouts. Impressively, the engine connects to the airframe at just 10 points, allowing for swift replacement without special equipment. Although the engine has exceptional speed, the design of the F-18 engine is quite simple. Only 4 engine men can remove and replace it within a mere 20 minutes. In the Arctic, the U.S. Coast Guard conducts routine inspections of the propulsion system. The unique environment of the polar region adds extra pressure on certain components. While a significant portion of the engine can be examined internally, external parts must be inspected from the outside. Therefore, divers jump into the freezing water to carry out these inspections. Beneath the ice sheets, divers meticulously check the propellers of Cutter Healy. They carefully scrutinize the propellers, assessing their condition and ensuring they remain free from ice accumulation or damage. In 2020, Cutter Healy encountered a significant setback when its main propulsion motor caught fire during Arctic deployment. Subsequently, the vessel was transferred to a dry dock in California for extensive repairs. The operation involved replacing the damaged motor with the spare unit. This task required creating a large hole in the ship's dual hull. Then, the operators extracted the damaged motor and placed the new unit. The final step involved reinstalling removed parts and welding them back to the ship's integral hull. After overhaul, Cutter Healy resumed operations by embarking on new missions. She has got back to its full operational capacity, providing scientists with a mobile laboratory to explore the Arctic. The new motor and all the technology on board enable researchers to conduct experiments, collect data, and study the impacts of climate change. That is the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Make sure to subscribe to this channel so you don't miss any of our new content.